Africa was the focus of the United Nations 63rd General Assembly, and Nigeria's foreign image maker, who doubles as the head of delegation, touched on a number of issues ranging from poverty, underdevelopment, sectarian violence in Sudan, among others. He urged the international community to rally around Africa.
The entire debt relief amount that we got have been put into the Millennium Development Goals. So it's not for want of trying that we still have serious problems. It is because the problems we have, whether in Nigeria or in the rest of Africa, is far beyond our capacity. And so we have used this opportunity to renew call, not for aid in the classical sense of it, but that the roadblocks for global prosperity, just like the Berlin Wall, had to be torn down. Those roadblocks should be removed.
Chief Ojo Maduekwe says Africa's problem is a global one, especially the scandalous food crisis should be treated as a global emergency.
That the world is flat. The world cannot be flat in some parts of the world and be round elsewhere. If it's flat, it better be flat all over. Because the danger in not allowing it to be flat everywhere is that there will be no barriers between the richest part of the world and the poorest part of the world in terms of pandemics and all the other consequences of underdevelopment and poverty. The global village cannot afford compounds of affluence living side by side with compounds of misery, because the whole intimacy of the global village means that it is either shared prosperity or it's going to be shared misery.
The minister from the sixth largest oil producing nation in the world says the Niger Delta restiveness is top priority.
What was the legitimate quest for fairness and for justice have been hijacked by a few criminal elements who obviously find criminality more profiteering than having peace and development come to the area known as Niger Delta. Now, we are asking the international community to treat oil bunkering, to criminalize oil bunkering and treat it the same way that the diamonds that were being stolen and were being used to fuel the civil war in Sierra Leone and create insurgencies in other parts of Africa, when international political will and genius came together and made the issue of blood diamonds an international issue.
On the state of President Umaro Yar'Adua's health?
Is the health of every other president not an issue? What makes that of Nigeria such a special case? You see why I said that kind of speculation is itself extremely unhealthy and sometimes is gratuitously insulting to the people of Nigeria. We, with due respect, acknowledge that there are some who have made this reference to health out of genuine concern, and we respect that concern. We appreciate that concern. But we also know that there are those who have made it an industry for mischief. But we will urge those who mean well and those who don't mean well to please, let's deal with issues of how the economy is running, how the nation is being administered. That to us is a more respectable way of treating the president of Nigeria and the people and government of Nigeria.
Thank you.
The 63rd United Nations General Assembly ends this week with the ministerial meeting of the Organization of Islamic Countries. Chidi Nwachukwu, AIT.